Okay, so this is our constant head permeameter. This is consistent for measuring soil permeability with Australian Standard 1547 for on-site effluent disposal and that kind of stuff. So it's a graduated cylinder with graduations in millimetres and centimetres on the column, and it's got a stopper on this end which goes down into a hole that you've augured to 50 centimetres or 500 millimetres deep. And so what you do is you make sure that the stopper is fixed in like that when you put it in the hole, but first you've got to fill it with water. So I don't fill it quite to the top because I still want to be able to read the graduation. So I've put the stopper so it's stopping the water. And then at the top here, that is going to be the point at which I start. So that's at about 3 millimetres. So we'll just leave it, I'll measure it from this end. No, it is that end. And just leave that aside for the moment, but the hole that I've augured here is half a metre deep and it's about 75 millimetres diameter. So it's easy enough in sandy soils. If it's really gravelly, then it's quite hard to get the hole, you know, down to that depth. But if that's the case, then you might have to try something else than a hand auger. So the augured hole has to be saturated. So you always take a big glugger of water along. So you kind of watch the soil and see how much it's soaking up, so that you can see that starting to move away quite quickly. And so I'll just keep filling that up for a minute or so, just to make sure that the profile that we're testing is a little bit saturated. And the other things I've got with me is my own timer, because we're going to time the water dropping in this as the soil permeates through the soil. And I've got my form in here. So as the level drops in this, I'm reading against the graduated cylinder every 10 seconds. So at 10 second intervals, wherever the measure of the water is, that's what I write down until it gets down to the bottom of our graduated layer. So as you can see, the water is moving away, but it's not super fast. So that gives you a bit of an idea already about what you're likely to expect. So what I do now is I put the permeameter into the hand augured hole. So we're just about to start off. The current reading is at 1 centimetre. So we're going to let the water go. There's bubbles, now we wait for the next set of bubbles. And that's when we'll set our time again. So when the bubbles take this long, it's usually a bit of a sign that you've got either moderate or relatively low permeability. 5 centimeters.
Seconds, we're at 1.8. Seconds, we're at 2.3. 40 seconds, we're at 2.6. 50 seconds, we're at 3.2.
So you go on like that down that column until you get to where you feel that you're getting pretty regular intervals. So I'll, just for the sake of showing you, I won't do any more. But some other things to think of is that there's no point doing this test if the if you've got groundwater to the surface of the ground. It's just not going to tell you anything about the permeability of the soil in terms of the Australian standard. So you want the hole to have to be saturated, but not into really wet ground. It's just not going to act like the soil normally would. I think that's about it. Just another thing with the permeameter is you have to take some information about the site setting. So when you auger the hole, you need to describe the soil profile, and you've got to note any impermeable surfaces that you come across, like an ironstone layer or something else that you feel might affect the permeability of the soil generally. Because while you're in situ, you need to take that kind of thing into account for the overall permeability of the soil. The other things that you need to measure are the condition of the soil. Is it wet or is it dry? Like I said, if it's saturated with groundwater at the surface, then you can't really take this as being a proper test. Whether it's vegetation around you or it's compacted or anything like that that you notice from when you're setting up, it's a good thing to note those down.